हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू आर फाइन। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बिगिन विद अ यूनिट 4.1 अंडर द ग्रीनवुड ट्री, अ पोएम बाय विलियम शेक्सपियर। काइंडली रिमूव योर टेक्स्ट बुक, पेज नंबर 79। नाउ अंडर द ग्रीनवुड ट्री, स्टूडेंट्स, अंडर द ग्रीनवुड ट्री, it is a poem written by William Shakespeare. He tries to convey to us that the happiness one gets living in the nature, surrounded by all the wonders created by God. In this poem, he is inviting to everyone. He's inviting to you to live in the nature and experience the magic of nature. He invites people to come and relax in the green forest, away from their daily routine of the life, and enjoy the beauty of nature. He also tells the people that in the forest, their only enemy would be the weather, which could be easily tackled. So, let us move ahead with the poem. Under the greenwood tree, who loves to lie with me and turn his merry note unto the sweet bird's throat. Come hither, come hither, come hither. Here shall he see no enemy but winter and rough weather. So, in this stanza, William Shakespeare, he's telling us about the happiness of living in the nature without fearing one's enemies. The poet invites the people who share his feelings to join him under the greenwood tree. He say that these people should sing merrily and listen to the cheery note of the happier bird. He asks them to come here there and for they shall see no enemies there except the winter and the rough weather. Now, here the word hither is being used. It is a form of the old English. The meaning is here. And rough weather is, it is a winter time. Now, coming to the second stanza. Who doth ambition shun and loves to live in the sun, seeking the food he eats and pleased with what he gets, come hither, come hither, come hither. Here shall he see no enemy but winter and rough weather. So the second stanza, the poet, he is asking to those people who do not pursue ambition, who love to live in the sun and are happy with the food that they get to eat, to come there into the lap of the nature. He repeats that they shall see no enemies there except the winter and the rough weather. So the poet is telling you all that come here and relax in the lap of the nature and forget all the worries of your life. So here the word he's using is shun. That means too, it is when you are avoiding or when you are rejecting something, it is known as shun. And then hither is an old word, that is old English, that is meaning is come here. Now the message in the poem is that if one wants to live, that means he wants to enjoy, he wants to live a peaceful life without any tensions, enemies and problems. He should spend his life in nature, wherein he would be happy and relaxed. He should forget all the desires and rejoice in the glory of nature and feel like a free bird. So the poet, he's telling he, but it does not mean any particular boy or man, but he is symbolizing that anyone, whoever wants to wish to live a peaceful life, without any tensions or enemies and problems, and should spend the life in the nature, and he will feel or she will feel happy and relaxed, and surely would enjoy and rejoice the glory of the nature and feel like a happy bird moving here and there. So now coming to the rhyming words. Rhyming words: tree, me, note, throat, then see, enemy. Now coming to the hither, weather, and shun, sun, eats and gets. Now the rhyme scheme of the first four lines is A-A-B-B, tree, me, same sound, so A, note, throat, B. So the rhyme scheme for the first four lines is A-A-B-B. But coming to the rhyme scheme of this last four lines is A-B-B-A, because the sound is changing here. For example, sun, eats, gets, so A, B, B, A. Sun and hither, sounds are different. Okay, then coming to the figures of speech. Now, figures of speech, if you look at the first stanza, come hither is being repeated again and again. So here it is repetition, the words come hither has been repeated for better poetic effect. And when you look at this one, inversion is also used. Now if we see here that here shall he see no enemy, so the proper form or the proper order should be here he shall see no enemy. And who doth ambition shun, even this is also here inversion is used. The proper order should be who doth shun ambition. Now see, who doth ambition shun, so who doth shun ambition is the correct order. And the old words used in this are hither, that means towards, here, and doth, that is does. So I hope that you all have understood this poem very well. And this poem or this song is an extract from the William Shakespeare's play As You Like It. And this play was being written in the 16th and the earlier 17th century. And very famous comedy play As You Like It. So I hope that you all have understood this poem very well. So children, if you like my educational video, kindly like it and subscribe it. Thank you children, and God bless you all.